Hello everyone, welcome to week 36. This is my weekly PhD vlogs. If you have not followed me, then follow me in Twitter and Instagram. You'll find a lot of suggestions and advice from my PhD life about studying and living in Netherlands and doing a PhD in Netherlands. And also follow me in the join the Facebook group if you want to ask dedicated questions, because I'm very busy so I cannot take personal questions, but I can offer time in Skype if people are interested to interact depending on my schedule. And I can also we have a short team in the Facebook group. If you join the Facebook group, then you can ask a lot of questions and we'll answer all your questions with time. It will take some time for us because we are doing this work, not paid for this work, we are doing it voluntarily. As you can see from the title, this week I gained a lot of things from Twitter with respect to my PhD, so that's why I'm going to discuss about that. So Alexa, what is Twitter?
The verb Twitter is usually defined as to utter a succession of small, tremulous sounds, as a bird. The noun Twitter is usually defined as an act of twittering.
Alexa, why should I use Twitter?
Here's something I found on Wikipedia. Twitter is mainly used by older adults who might not have used other social sites before Twitter.
Okay, I don't think it's true. I mean, considering the number of younger entrepreneurs and academicians nowadays in Twitter, because of the advantages of Twitter, like it has a short word limit. I think it's now like, I don't remember exactly, but I think it's like 140 characters or something like that. So it has a very short word limit, so your message cannot be very vague. If you want to post something big, then you need to post as individual tweets, like first tweet, second tweet, third tweet as a thread. So what happens is that it's not like Facebook or Instagram. You don't have noise. Normally it is mostly used to communicate something in very short and precise manner. And you can meet a lot of people. Like in my case, I had my Twitter account from 2012, but I started using it actively when I was just finishing my master's and looking for PhD positions, because I thought like it's such an insightful tool. If you follow the right set of people, or maybe right set of journals or communities out there, like maybe some magazines that you like, or maybe some journals like Human Computer Interaction, or in my case IEEE TLT, or I don't know, like some innovative technologies for education. That is what I'm doing in the research. So you can follow a lot of companies, groups, like-minded people, and you can get their updates and you learn things there a lot faster than you would by the traditional way of news or getting it from articles or papers or something like that. They are much delayed as compared to Twitter. So I started actively using it around 2017 or at the end of 2016 when I was just finishing my master's. And what it helped me was that I found some similar people who are doing research in the similar fields that I'm interested in. And even, you'll be surprised, I found the PhD position that I'm working on, the advertisement, via Twitter. I know I have mentioned many times that for PhD in Netherlands, you should use academic transfer. But Twitter is also a good non-conventional informal option where you can find a lot of articles beforehand. Like before something is published, most people post a preprint version of an article, and if you follow those like-minded people, then you will get this information really, really fast. And the advantage is it has this precise word limit, so that helps to like get the information in a very short, and it's not bogus, so it has something relevant, some meaning, otherwise it won't show up in your home feed. So I would advise you to have an account in Twitter and follow your research or your like-minded people, and it will help you a lot. You'll see in the research when something gets published, you will know beforehand before it actually appears in that journal or conference, you'll have a preprint version, or maybe depending on your tweets, by seeing your tweets when you share your research and increase your view count, people might contact you by direct message. There's a direct message option in Twitter, or maybe you never know, because I was for a year following an Australian researcher who works exactly in my similar field via Twitter. And we also exchange something, like when he posts a preprint, you need to be proactive. So I sometimes I read that paper and I like the article, and I also cite it in my literature review while doing it. And I just message, like retweet it with a comment like, this article has this XYZ points, which are really very insightful, innovative and relevant for my case. So I like this article. And then he saw it repeatedly, and he also liked the way I was communicating without any direct contact. And after some time, he followed me. So there are, like, I think basically two options in Twitter, like following each other. You can follow people and then they will show up in your feed if they post something or retweet. And there is a like button. So I would advise you to follow Twitter. It will help you a lot to advance your research career, academic career, or maybe while finding jobs, getting in touch with people. Just like LinkedIn, it is a non-formal way of, it's much different from LinkedIn, but you should have a Twitter account. And in case you don't know, I also have a Twitter account. Maybe I'll tag it here, or you can see it in my homepage of my profile in the YouTube. So you can follow me on Twitter. And the best way to learn Twitter is by following people. Like, if you're a newbie to the Twitter, then just see how people tweet and retweet what they retweet. Just watch it. Try to do something different or copy it, and then you will learn the patterns of which tweets are relevant for you, which are not. If you follow the certain specific set of people that you want to see in your feed, you'll always end up in the right place. So I hope you like this video. I don't know if I mentioned properly about Twitter, but I mentioned what based on my experience. And I think you like the video, then smash the thumbs up button. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, and see you in week 37. Till then, peace out.